Now, the essence of logic is that it divides everything in life into two categories. Is it this or that? Heads or tails? Good or bad? Black or white? It must be one or the other. There are no shades of gray in logic. True or false? Yes or no? On or off? Which is where the computer comes in, because its circuits must also be either on or off. The other important thing about logic is the logical argument itself, which goes something like this. All tall men are thin. Jim is a tall man, therefore Jim is thin. If the first two statements are true, we can be absolutely certain that the third statement is true. On the other hand, if there are some tall men who are not thin, then we can't be sure that the third statement is true. And in black and white logic, if we can't be sure that it's true, then it must be false. Which is where the computer comes in again, because this is precisely the sort of argument that an electrical circuit likes to deal with. If we imagine one of these circuits as being like this, with a power source, a battery, two switches, and a light bulb, then we can see that the electric current from the battery can only reach the light bulb and make it light up when both switches are on. If either switch goes off, the light goes out. Now, as far as the circuit is concerned, on or off can just as easily stand for true or false. So if the first switch is statement one in our logical argument, and the second switch is statement two, and the light bulb is statement three, then only when both of the first two statements are true can the third statement also be true. But if either of the first two statements is false, then the third statement must also be false. What all this boils down to is that a computer is not a calculating machine. It's a logic machine.